Hey everybody, I have tea. Oh my god. Now as we all know, fraternities and sororities can be a huge part of campus life. They're pretty much the only thing that you hear about as an incoming freshman, and yet they're also the most mysterious thing on campus. People don't really understand how the rush process works, how the pledge process works, who gets cut versus who goes to the next round. But anyway, I wanted to confirm or deny some myths regarding fraternities. Obviously, my experience is going to be a bit different than other fraternities and sororities because mine was a gender-neutral LGBT organization. But we surprisingly still did follow a lot of Greek life stereotypes, albeit I think in a more calm way. So I'm just gonna start telling you my experience. Coming into college, I was actually very against the idea of Greek life in general because I had seen, you know, movies like Neighbors and, I don't know, other things that just show you how bro-y and kind of like gross frat life culture is. However, one of the first days on campus, I saw this beautiful chalking on the ground, all in rainbow. I couldn't really resist checking it out. For those of you who don't know, the rush process is pretty straightforward. There's a week full of events for people that are interested in the fraternity to go meet the members, and you just kind of try and connect with people and see if you get the vibe that you would fit in with this crowd. The organization that I was rushing had three different events. One was a game night, G-A-Y-M-E, like game night. There was a dinner, I think. Casually looking at my script. Luckily, I was actually having a really great time with these people. We were playing games like Cards Against Humanity, stuff like that. And my humor really matched the humor of some of the members there, so I was just really having a lot of fun. And to meet other queer people on campus, like so quickly as a freshman, was really astonishing to me coming from a small town. And even though Rush is kind of a competition in its nature because you're trying to make connections with these people more than other people rushing are, the members didn't treat it like it was a competition. They genuinely tried to be our friends. That was awesome, just having a room full of people really trying to get along with you. So at the end of the week, after all of the rush events, the people that the fraternity wanted to keep were supposed to get a bid, which is basically just terminology for they want you. It's like a formal invitation to start pledging the fraternity. However, what really happened was a little different. Instead of getting a bid, at the end of the week, I actually got an invitation to a party instead. It turns out that the members wanted to see certain people in a social setting. I mean, the other things were a social setting, but they were more formal, and this was like a college party. It was alcohol, dancing, shenanigans. That actually turned out to be my first college party, and it was probably one of the most fun parties I've ever gone to in my entire life. I mean, they really set up for this party, y'all. They had rainbow jello shots, they had dancers in the basement, there was blaring music everywhere. It was really fun. So a few days after the party, we received our formal bids. There were about 30 some people that came to all the events, and I believe 20 of us received formal bids. At that point, all you have to do is just accept or deny the bid, and then you move on to the pledging process. So the pledging process is a bit different than Rush. It's more serious. At this point, the fraternity wants you, and you have to show that you want the fraternity. This is the part where it gets a little weird. Pledging is the process where you hear of a lot of people getting hazed in other organizations. Luckily, and I'm speaking the truth, I ain't lying, my organization did not haze at all. The closest they got was like handing out extra points for like doing chores for them. What are points, you may be asking? Well, at the end of the semester, we had to have a certain number of points to be eligible to be a member. Each week, we have a meeting, and in this meeting, we learn stuff about the LGBT community as well as the history of our organization. Every week we also had a test on this information, and how well you did on the test translated to how many points you would get each week. And you could earn extra points by, like I said before, doing extra stuff for members. So either helping at frat events or personal stuff like do my laundry, I don't know. Aside from learning about the organization, pledging is a process that gets you and your fellow classmates, that's what we were called, like our class, to work together and learn what it's like to be in a team with them. At first, they were just kind of like camp games. I think we played Red Rover. That was our first task as like a team. We were split into members versus like newbies. We also did other stuff. We had to blindfold someone and then give them directions on like how to build a tent blindfold. unfolded. Eventually, though, those tasks became more and more serious. We had to plan our own fundraising for the fraternity. We had to plan philanthropy events. We had to plan a talent show. I planned a talent show for this organization. Overall, pledging was actually my favorite part about being in the fraternity. I mean, we got to make friends, learn new skills, plan really cool events that we wanted to plan, and just have a good time with strangers. You were bonding. It was actually really cool. Not to mention that the parties spiced up my social life, which before then was kind of dead, so. At the end of the semester, there was a huge test which combined all the previous tests that we had in meetings each week, as well as seeing if you had enough points to cross over. And if you did, then you got to go to the crossover ceremony, which was kind of like, it was creepy, but like in a fun way. They like blindfolded us and like kind of dragged us through the woods. And that sounds like really scary, but it wasn't as creepy as I'm making it sound. We just had to do a few last tasks as a group together to really like commit to the organization. And that sounds creepy, but it was really just like, we had to like say a few words, come up with like a like saying for our like class or whatever. It was fun. It was cool. 16 of us made it out of the 20, by the way. So after the crossing over ceremony, you are obviously an official member of this organization now, or I was. I actually ended up leaving the organization and revoking my membership, but that was due to a lot of just personal drama that I was going through and didn't necessarily reflect the organization as a whole. There's no doubt that without that organization, my freshman year would have been completely different. I wouldn't have learned how to come out of my shell. I wouldn't be able to say that I had an amazing freshman year, because truly doing that is actually what made my experience great. I know a lot of people don't condone rushing, but if you want to, then I say go for it. Like I said, my experience is going to be very different than other fraternities or sororities, normal Greek life. If you want to do it, you should do it. And if you end up not wanting to do it along the way, you can always leave. Even if they make it sound scary, like, they got nothing on you. They can't do anything to you. So just do what you want at all times. It's your life. Do what you want. So that was my experience. I hope that you enjoyed listening to this and maybe gained a little bit of more insight into fraternities on campus, especially if there is an LGBT fraternity, sorority, or frorority. If you have any more questions on my experiences, because God knows I didn't say everything on here, please leave comments below or send me a message. Whatever you want to do is great. Thanks for stopping by to watch my video. Bye.